That's right, Norm. There was a packed auditorium here at St. Augustine High School this evening as one of their disciplinary traditions has come under scrutiny. Now, there was a meeting tonight that they did not want our cameras to go into, but we did get some video from inside the meeting, and you can tell that parents and students were certainly impassioned about this tradition of getting the paddle here at St. Augustine. Some even said that getting the paddle is what actually kept them on the straight and narrow. We talked to parents who currently have students at St. Augustine and who have sons who graduated from this high school. Both stand in support of corporal punishment. So as a parent, you don't mind that for your son?
Oh, no, I instill it. I do it at my own house, so it helps. It doesn't do anything but help.
Darling, it didn't hurt him. He's fine. He's a grown man now. He's doing well. And no harm ever came to him. He's never been to prison, never been picked up by the cops, none of that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. He did not suffer from a paddle once in his life.
Now, we should mention that this meeting lasted about 4 hours, after which we did get a chance to meet with Archbishop Gregory Amon. He says that since he's been at the helm of the Archdiocese, he actually has received complaints about the paddling at St. Augustine High School. He also says that there has been reports of injuries. He tells us that overall, the paddle just doesn't sit right with him.
Also that there is no other Catholic school in the United States that has corporal punishment. This is just something that has gone away. And, of course, the plea tonight, and I understand the plea, St. Aug is different, it's unique, the culture and so forth, and I think all those things have to be looked at. But it weighs heavy on my heart.
While we expect to have some ongoing dialogue, the stakeholders of the school, who are very important and critical to the continued success of the school, spoke clearly tonight. We heard their voices, and we expect to have some continued dialogue about that. But we want everyone to know that discipline has always been a hallmark of the St. Augustine educational experience, and it will continue to be a very high priority here, regardless of what happens in the discussions going forward.
So we should say tonight, after the four-hour marathon, it seemed, meeting, the thing that both sides agreed on is that there does need to be some discipline at the school, but just how to go about it is still unclear. That's the story for now. We're on your side in the 7th Ward. I'm Gina Swanson. Back to you.
All right, Gina. Archbishop Gregory Amon says nothing has been resolved tonight, obviously. He says he's praying on the issue and discussion continues.